Dion Wynn.
Hi everyone, welcome back. Maybe for the very first time, and I'm here again with another review for you. And today I'm going to be discussing Maggie Gyllenhaal's directorial debut, The Lost Daughter. And at the back end of Venice, I heard so many kind of like mixed positive reviews about this film. I was like, damn, I'm excited to see this film. And I got to see it at London Film Festival in October, to something that has actually been kind of stuck in my mind ever since. And yes, it is a striking debut. And to be honest, having Dakota Johnson, Olivia Colman, and Jesse Buckley in one film is always going to be exciting. So enough introducing, let's get talking. The film follows a college professor Lida who confronts her unsettling past after meeting a woman and her young daughter while on vacation. Her obsession with the woman and her daughter prompts memories of her early motherhood. The Lost Daughter is just emotionally striking. I thought it was one of the best debuts I have seen in 2021, and Maggie Gyllenhaal deserves so much applause and praise for this film. I think in a weird way it's not necessarily getting the traction it deserves. It's done quite well at the Gotham Awards, and I think it actually won the most awards that night. But for me, this really has a lot to say, and it kind of breaks conformities of discussing motherhood, and I thought that was really the focal part of this. It was brutally honest, and it just shows a woman who is suffocating and who has really gone through the motions of life and really reflecting on lost life because of motherhood. And I really found that to be so profound, and it's so intimately kind of explained by Maggie Gyllenhaal. And it doesn't necessarily spoon feed all this information to you, but what it really does within its kind of like offbeat rhythm, it allows this narrative to flow in a pretty rigorous way. And there are really tender, soft moments, and then there's these bursts of anger, aggression, sadness that really just kind of balance each other out so well through each frame. And I really found this to be so thought-provoking, because it kind of asks you the question of, is this common, and is this something that a lot of parents go through? I found that to be one of the big kind of like foods for thought I had while watching it. But what I really enjoyed about Gyllenhaal's direction here is her way that she kind of tightens the frame on the face. And we are observing quite a lot, because Lida is sitting on a beach and she's watching all these families and children just having fun. And this is kind of the time when she reflects. And I think this happens quite a lot with people when they kind of sit down and think about what has happened in their lives. This is kind of the tumultuous kind of feelings that you have. And I found that to be some of the best scenes in this film. And as this kind of story unfolds, it really becomes more dramatic, it really becomes more deeply harrowing and enlightening. And for me, it was just that kind of moment in time where I thought to myself, damn, this has a lot to say. And this is what makes debuts so important, is when they have these moments. But what I really like, the way it kind of interweaved the present leader and the young leader, and the young leader is played by Jesse Buckley. And I really like the way that Gyllenhaal kind of interweaved this whole kind of narrative. It really kind of explored the kind of the beginning of who Lida is now, and the issues that she does have with her own children. And I found that to be beautifully kind of canvassed. But the only issue I had with this really was that it doesn't really explore Dakota Johnson's character that much, because she is that mother with the young child going through some issues. And while I feel like probably it wasn't that crucial at times, it really was important to me, because I really found this parallel of past and present coming together to be so profound, and it really just needed ironing out in that form. I will be honest with you, Olivia Colman gives the best performance of her career, in my humble opinion. This is far greater than what you see in The Favourite. I think she kind of channels so much energy and fire in this, because she's so quiet but ferocious, and these kind of bursts that she has within the film are just absolutely outstanding. And I really think that Jesse Buckley kind of fits the mannerism so well with her. They complement the character because you see two sides of a coin, but these two sides of a coin seem familiar, but they're not necessarily the same. And this evolution that they have is really fantastic. And I really like Dakota Johnson. I'm a big fan of her work anyway, and I think within this, she kind of channeled this young mother going through a lot of issues so well. I just wish there was more of her. But all in all, Lost Daughter, one of the best films I'd seen this year. It really has kind of been burrowing in my mind ever since I watched it, and I really can't not wait to watch it again later on this month when it's on Netflix. So I hope you enjoyed this review. I'll be back with a couple more reviews before the end of the year, and obviously my top 25 of 2021. So I hope you're doing well, staying safe, and I will speak to you soon. So bye-bye.